For balancing chemical equations, you want to make the reactants be the same exact number as your products. Always start with balancing everything other than hydrogen and oxygen. Leave hydrogen and especially oxygen for the very end. All right, let's get started. Here we have an unbalanced equation. Our first step is to write all of our elements for our reactants and all the elements that we have for our products on either side, and I'm going to keep them in the exact same order to make it easier to balance. Now, my tip for you is for any polyatomic atoms on the same that are the same on actually both sides, like our OH and our OH here, do not separate them. We're going to leave the OHs intact to make it a lot easier to balance everything out. All right, so now let's get back to our reactants and see how many of each reactant we have. Looking at barium, we only have one. Chlorine, this subscript tells us we have two. Na, we only have one. OH has no subscript or parentheses with a subscript, so then we're just gonna say that there's only one OH. Now going to our products, we'll see that barium only has one. Now I'm going to look at OH for right now and see that there's actually a 2 subscript. That 2 only affects the OH group, not barium. So this is saying there are 2 OHs. So 2 OHs. And then we'll have 1 Na, or sodium, and 1 Cl, or 1 chlorine. Now, the next step is to figure out, okay, where are we gonna start? What do we wanna balance? So we have to balance out our chlorine because there's 2 on this side and only 1 on the other. And then for OH, there's only 1 on our reactant side and 2 on our products. Always begin with everything other than hydrogen and oxygen. So I'm actually gonna start with the chlorine first. So since there's a 2 here, I need 2 more on the product side. So I'm gonna place a 2 right in front of that compound. Note that you cannot put the 2 in the center because that's then breaking apart the compound altogether. And since this is a compound, this 2 will actually distribute and affect the Na and the chlorine. So I'm going to actually recount everything now. If we were to recount everything, we'll see that we have 2 Nas, and now we have 2 chlorine. But nothing changed with barium or our OH, so we still have 2. Now looking on the reactant side, I'm gonna now continue to balance out the Na. So we need 2 on our reactant side. This would then distribute to both again, and we'll see that this affects our Na because we now have 2 on that side and we have 2 OHs. Everything else remains the same, and we're balanced. Here we have our next unbalanced equation. Remember to start with writing all of the different elements you have for your reactant side and for your products, keeping that in the exact same order to help you balance it out. Now, I'm always gonna leave hydrogen for the second to last and oxygen for the very last. It makes it so much easier. Oxygen tends to balance out at the very end. Now, looking at this, I'm just gonna count how many of each element we have. So looking at this subscript, we have 2 carbon on our reactant side. Looking at the 4 subscript, we have 4 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. Now looking on our product side, we'll see there's only 1 carbon. That 2 affects this oxygen. However, there's actually another oxygen here, so don't forget about that. There sometimes can be other oxygen in other compounds, and I'm gonna look at this and actually count it up. So there's 2 plus that 1 oxygen, making there be 3 oxygen on our product side. Next, we only have 2 hydrogen due to this subscript. And let's look and see, and really nothing is balanced whatsoever. We have our work ahead of us. So looking at carbon, that's where I want to begin, because remember, hydrogen is second to last, then oxygen. So carbon, I can place a 2 right in front of that CO2 compound, and this affects our carbon and our oxygen because it's like you're distributing. And I say that because we're gonna multiply this 2 times this other 2 for our oxygen and then recount everything. So if I'm gonna recount and see what's affected by this 2, there's actually 2 carbon on our product side and 2 times 2, so 4. 4 plus this other 1 oxygen, making it 5. So we now have 5 oxygen on our product side and nothing happened with hydrogen, so that stayed the exact same. Now let's go back to our reactant side and then we'll balance out our hydrogen. So we'll see there's only 4 on this side and we have only 2 on our product side. So I need 2 more because you're looking at what we'll multiply by this subscript to give us 4. So 2 times 2 gives us 4. I'm gonna recount everything again. So this would have been 4 hydrogen and nothing else changed, except our oxygen did, right? So because I'm gonna actually distribute that 2, our hydrogen changed and our oxygen, now we have 2 plus the 4 that was here, so we now have 6, almost done. Last thing is oxygen to balance out. So what do we need to multiply oxygen by to get 6? So 3 times 2 will give us 6. So I'll place a 3 in front of that O2 and recount everything on our reactant side. And we'll see that 3 times that 2 gives us 6. And right there, we are balanced. I did another video with more practice problems of balancing chemical equations. Make sure you check that out because guys, to really understand chemistry and to not have to take this class again, Yay! Practice is truly the key.